The Kardashians might be the most famous family on the globe, but their public drama pales in comparison to the dark secrets they've tried to keep out of the spotlight. From Kim's love life to Kylie's lips to Khloe's baby fever, here are the dark secrets this family tried to hide. Feeling the weight. Rob Kardashian has had it tough. Days before his older sister Kim married Kanye West, Rob went off the rails tweeting about his weight. In since-deleted posts, he wrote, "So I found out I was trending for being fat. Thank you all, it really made my day." It all came to a head after he was diagnosed with diabetes in 2015 and was hospitalized for it in December 2016. TMZ reported Rob checked himself into the hospital because his condition flared up thanks to weight gain during his stressful relationship to Blac Chyna. It was a shocker since just months earlier, he told People that Chyna helped rid him of the disease, saying, "She told me that by having her cook for me, my diabetes would be gone, and it is." Faking it. Was Khloe's 7-year marriage to Lamar Odom a total sham? No, but she did fake wanting to have kids with the former NBA star. During an episode of Cocktails with Khloe, she shared they were once planning to have a family, saying, "Lamar and I wanted to conceive. We wanted to adopt, but also to foster kids." But in a recent episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Khloe admitted to faking trying to get pregnant with Lamar, revealing to a fertility doctor,
"Like I was married, but I knew the circumstances weren't the healthiest, so I just kept pretending I was doing."
Lamar told Wendy Williams in 2017,
"That hurt a little bit, but I wish she didn't have to go. She could have told me." Yeah. "I had to say it to you on TV."
On TV. Well,
yeah.
But Lamar wasn't exactly innocent himself. Sex, lies, and marriage. Khloe did all she could to convince everyone that her marriage to Lamar was working, revealing to her family, "I kept in hiding every time there was something going on. I would have to lie or conceal or cover up, and I'm so over it." A year after their divorce was finalized, Lamar told Us Weekly in 2017,
"I wish I could have kept my d*** in my pants."
Yeah.
"If there's one thing that I regret, multiple affairs with different women, it wasn't a stand-up thing to do. She didn't deserve that."
Lamar, who overdosed and nearly died in 2015, said he got an apartment in Los Angeles just so he could get high freely, out of sight from his wife, admitting, "I wasn't trying to repair my marriage, I was just trying to get high." Transformations. In Caitlyn's memoir, The Secrets of My Life, she alleges that Chris 100% knew of her gender identity crisis when they met, adding that Chris was fully aware she was on hormones for years before meeting, writing, "I told her there had been a woman inside me all my life." Chris disagrees. In an episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, Chris said the book was filled with lies.
"Everything she says is all made up." And then all through the book, Chris knew. "Chris knew before I even made love to her." I'm like, what?
Kim believes Chris and Caitlyn will probably never reconcile, telling Andy Cohen where the chance of the former lovers ever talking again ranks for her.
"No, I would say 2%, and those are Kendall and Kylie."
Lips don't lie. Kylie Jenner regrets not coming clean about her lip injections at age 16. Talking with Complex, the teen star remembers giving countless interviews in which she lied about getting her lips enhanced. Kylie says she developed an insecurity about the size of her lips after a guy kissed her in middle school and complained that her lips were too thin. She said, "From then on, I just felt like I saw guys staring at my lips. I felt like no one wanted to kiss me." Kylie said she thought the best course of action was to lie, but later admitted, "These kids, my fans, I didn't want to be a bad influence. I didn't want them to think you had to get your lips done to feel good about your face. I wish I had just been honest up front." Under pressure. The fashion industry has fallen in love with Kendall Jenner, but as the model described on Keeping Up with the Kardashians in late 2016, she suffers from both panic attacks and sleep paralysis. Things became so intense that Chris recruited a therapist to coach Kendall. Chris also flew from Los Angeles to London just so Kendall would feel comfortable on a plane. Writing in an end-of-year blog post via Teen Vogue, Kendall described her use of breathwork to manage the episodes, saying, "Anxiety was a huge hurdle for me to deal with this past year, but I think I'm finally learning how to cope." Keeping up appearances. Watching Kim's fairy tale wedding, a Kardashian event, no one would suspect Kim's marriage to NBA star Kris Humphries was already falling apart. But behind closed doors, Kim had a feeling it wouldn't last long. She later told Andy Cohen,
"I just thought, holy shit, I'm 30 years old. I better get this together. I better get married." It was more of that situation.
In all, the couple were married for 72 days. Kim's divorce filing not only shocked the world, but it shocked Humphries, who claims he was blindsided. He told TMZ, "I'm committed to this marriage and everything this covenant represents. I love my wife and am devastated to learn she filed for divorce. I'm willing to do whatever it takes to make it work." Unfortunately, their marriage ended in a long, bitter divorce, which was finally settled in 2013 after Kim's infamous cry face. On the rocks. Scott Disick first began showing signs of extreme abuse and misbehavior in 2010. Keeping Up with the Kardashian cameras showed him seriously intoxicated and shoving a $100 bill down a waiter's throat after his drinks were cut off. Things became more and more horrifying until in 2014, while filming a Hampton spinoff, Courtney kicked him out of their shared rental home. Scott has been to rehab 4 times, with his latest trip in the fall of 2015. Courtney said on The Hamptons Show, "This behavior has been going on for years." Scott confessed to feeling lonely, saying, "It's been a really hard time going from having all of you guys to having nobody." In 2017, Scott, who has 3 kids with Courtney, doesn't appear to be getting any better. He's been spotted with countless women all over the world, including Bella Thorne, with whom he partied in France. Breakdown. Following his wife's 2016 Paris robbery, Kanye's world began to fall apart. He canceled his St. Pablo tour and checked himself in to UCLA Medical Center for help. E! News claims the star was suffering from exhaustion and sleep deprivation, but there were signs things weren't okay in the weeks leading up to his breakdown, including several onstage rants taped by fans in which he targeted Jay-Z, saying,
"Call me. After the robbery, say how you feeling. You want to know how I'm feeling? Come by the house."
TMZ reported the rapper ultimately became unstable after screwing up the dosage of his medication, adding that Kanye has long suffered from psychological issues, which are controlled by the medication. Insiders tell E! News Kanye's balancing his life much better these days. Factory Girl. After taking fans on a virtual tour of the factory where her Good American Denim is manufactured, Khloé found out some fans didn't exactly like what they saw, claiming she was running a sweatshop. The footage showed workers creating jeans by hand in a warehouse with unfinished floors. In one video, she's even heard warning the workers,
"Don't f*** it up. All the pressure's on you."
Khloé fired back, tweeting, "Watch your mouth. All make salaries and all are employed in Los Angeles. Know your info before you chime in. It means a lot to me to fight to make my denim in the US and to be employing good wages to all of my hardworking employees." Thanks for watching! Click the Nikki Swift icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too!